Hey, Blue Table fans. Today, we're taking a look at the painted version of that miniature I was showing you the other day. And it's really not a miniature because this thing is huge. In fact, let me get a regular 25 millimeter base, 28 millimeter figure next to it. This thing is huge. And it's so, and I'm gonna talk about this in a minute, but first off, a little plug for Raven North. I found them on Etsy. They got a great shop. And the other thing is, these guys are professionals, A to Z, in every way. They're absolutely great. Highly recommend. All right, first off, the base, it comes with this base. There's nothing wrong with it. It's certainly great for display. And as you can see, it has little hoof prints on it that show you where the legs go, and they're indented, so that gives you a little extra traction when you're gluing this thing together. In terms of pieces, it has a head piece, it has a thorax piece, and then this giant tail piece. And Raven North did an exquisite job printing this. Everything lined up absolutely to the micrometer. It just looks so good. And then each of the six legs is separate as well. Now I replaced it with this oval base, which I had in my collection. I think it looks great. I did some good corking on there. I put this little orc skull on it too, which is something I had in my collection. And I'm super pleased with the base. Now normally I would have picked some colors, probably green. I love green and purple. It's a great combination. I'll try to be a little more subtle about it. But in this case, I decided to go all earth tones and with a light dark contrast on the underneath here on the skin areas, I've highlighted it almost up to white. And on the back, it's a brick red. It does have some greens, a little bit of purples in there. Yeah, I managed to work in the green and purple. And reds, ivories, blacks, these little horns go up to black, which I think looks extremely handsome. The really cool feature of this is this hammerhead type head. It looks really good. I imagine it has like sonar. In the game, I'm gonna make stats for this thing and it's gonna be a very interesting tactical creature. Like a tribe of humanoids runs along with this thing. So anyway, on the bottom, very fleshy tones there again with some reds and greens and purples and stuff. Working it up. Oh, I guess you saw the bottom of the base there. So anyway, this model looks really, really, really incredibly cool. Look at the head there. Ah! This thing is just so detailed. And I was surprised at the price, at how little it costs. This is their 100 millimeter scale. And this is actually bigger. This is twice as big as I thought it was going to be. I thought the whole thing was going to be like 6 inches long. Like that, but instead it's over a foot long. And quite frankly, for the price adjustment, may as well just get the more awesome, larger version of it. And so this is, by the way, it's called a Trilogira, and I'm gonna give it my own name in my own fantasy game. And it's an incredibly cool model. Oh my gosh, really inventive, evocative, captures the imagination. It's just put together and 3D sculpted so well that like all the little features, the way it curves around, there's little vents on the side of the neck. It's just got so many awesome things about it. And there you have it. And it comes with this really cool base, great for a display. For play, probably still good because this top part is so light. All right, anyway, thanks for tuning in, and I just know you got your inspiration for the day.